today I'm going to give you a tour of my home office / YouTube studio that I've built up over the past 3 or so years. I genuinely love this space and I kind of have to pinch myself every day when I come in here and start my day's work. We'll go through my secondary desk, my primary desk, and then my storage. Hopefully it will give you some ideas on how you might be able to set up your own home office. So starting off with my secondary desk, this is a standing desk from Everdesk and I've really loved this desk. I've got a walnut top with a matching riser, which I think is really nice. This was my first ever sit stand desk and it's definitely sold me on standing desks, I'm not gonna lie. One of my favorite things about the Everdesk is that it's got this cable management slot at the back of the desk, which enables you to slide your cables through just to keep everything nice and clean and tidy. With the Everdesk, I have the ErgoTune Supreme version 3. I've had this chair for a while and I've really enjoyed using it. I still love it, it's super ergonomic, which is good for me as someone who tends to slouch in my chair. On the actual desk, I have an Orbit Key desk mat and this is the black version in the extra large size. And again, I really love it. Feels super nice and premium. I love how it's got the slot at the top where I can put pens or even rest my phone while I'm working. And I think it's the perfect size for the Everdesk. The key theme in my office, which I'm continually adding to, is indoor plants. And I feel like I'm constantly rotating where my plants are sitting, but currently I've got 2 on my secondary desk getting some light from the window. And then sitting on top of the riser, I've got the Orbit Key Nest. Now, to be honest, I actually don't use the charging feature on this anymore, but I just really like the look of it. I think it looks really nice and clean. And I do use it as a bit of storage for some odd cables. Next to that, I've got a Nokia 5G modem. All my internet in my apartment is run off 5G. I don't have wired internet, but I've got the modem connected via Ethernet to my MacBook and I get really great speed, so I'm very happy with it. And then lastly, I have a desk lamp. And with this desk lamp, I've got a smart bulb in it. And I mainly just use this light for mood lighting while I'm sitting at this desk or to just warm up the room when I'm working at night at my main desk. And I've had this lamp for ages, since the very early days of my first desk setup. All right, so moving on to my primary desk. And this is the one that I work on the most. The desk itself is an Omnidesk Ascent in pheasant wood. And again, I've got a matching riser in pheasant wood. And I absolutely love this desk. I love the look of it. I love the fact that it's real hardwood and I love the size. I got the larger size and I feel like it's the perfect size for me. It lets me kind of spread out and feel comfortable, but it's not so big that it takes up unnecessary amounts of room in my pretty small office. Plus, I love that the controller has a little USB port on the side of it where I'm regularly charging my devices like my phone and my camera. Now, the chair I'm sitting on primarily at the moment is the Omnidesk Embrace. And it's kind of 2 reasons why this is my primary chair over the ErgoTune at the moment. And that is the fact that I really love the cushion seat. It's actually really nice and comfy. And the cushion is actually warmer and it's winter at the moment. So in summer, I might move back to the ErgoTune because it's got the mesh and so it helps you stay cooler. Plus, I love how it looks. I love the gray and white aesthetic. I think it gives a really nice contrast against a lot of the rest of the black accessories I've got in my office. And again, it's super ergonomic. It does an amazing job of making sure my posture stays correct. Now, moving on to my monitor, which is arguably the centerpiece of my office. It's definitely the thing in my office that I spend the most time looking at. And I've got the LG 38WN95C ultrawide monitor. And honestly, I love it. I've had it for over a year now, I'm pretty sure. It's one of those purchases that I've just never regretted buying. I find it such a pleasure to work on. And I've done some other videos just on this monitor, so feel free to check them out. I've got it sitting on a Prism Plus monitor arm that I got from Omnidesk. And again, this just does a great job of utilizing the space that I've got on my desk. Now, moving down a little bit, I've got a Grovemade desk mat in light gray. And this is actually the small size. And there's 2 reasons why I really like small size. The first is that you can see more of the really nice Omnidesk hardwood. And the other reason that actually kind of surprised me was that I actually really like the ability to be able to slide my keyboard and mouse out of the way if I want to write notes in my journal, for example, or just do other tasks on my desks where I want my keyboard and mouse out of the way. It also feels really nice and it's really nice quality. So I'm definitely a fan of Grovemade, even if they are a bit on the expensive side. On top of the Grovemade, I've got the Logitech MX Master Set. So this is the MX Keys, which I'm a big fan of. I got the PC Mac version, not just the Mac version. And then I've got the MX Master 3, which again is an amazing mouse. You've probably seen it before. I've used this for quite a while now and still really enjoy using it. Then just in front of that, I've got a Google Nest Mini, which I use to control a lot of my smart devices throughout the house and often ask it for other just random facts, like what's the weather. And then the machine that powers all of my content is the MacBook Pro 16-inch. It's a 2021 model. I got it with the M1 Pro chip and 16 gigabytes of memory. which might surprise you. But to be honest, it does everything that I need it to do. I haven't really had any major complaints. Lately, I've been streaming a bit more and it does struggle a little bit to keep up with streaming while I'm also trying to do some heavy editing, which I think is understandable given that it's only got 16 gigabytes of memory. But apart from that, I edit all of my videos on this Mac and I have no complaints when it comes to speed and efficiency. One day I'd love to upgrade to a Mac Studio, but for now, this is doing me an amazing job. Now over on the left side of my desk, I have a pegboard from Everdesk, which actually came with my second desk, but I just love the aesthetic of it. It just clips onto my desk and I use it to hang accessories like my headphones. Plus I hang a lot of my regular use cables on the pegboard and some of my other accessories like a pair of scissors and some remotes. Now, just next to my pegboard, I've got a Rode PSA 1 boom arm, and on the boom arm, I've got the Shure MV7. And again, I've done a whole nother video on the MV7, so feel free to check that out. But I think this is finally the place where I think I'll leave the mic. I've been trying different spots on my desk over the past few months to try and find the sweet spot where I can leave the mic and use it for streaming, shooting content, and all that type of stuff without having to move the boom arm around. And I think I finally found that spot in this corner. But yeah, it's an excellent mic, excellent boom arm. I really enjoy both of them. And then in terms of lighting, I've got three different lights on my desk. I've got this exposed bulb lamp, which I got from my mate Sanji. And I just love the aesthetic of it. Adds a lot of warmth to my desk. Then I've got a monitor light that just sits on top of my monitor, which I got from Everdesk. I think it's one of those accessories that everyone should have if you can. They're just great for lighting up your desktop without adding extra glare to your monitor or your eyes. And then finally, I have a Loom Cube Edge light, which I actually use for three different purposes. The first is for streaming. So I use it as my streaming light to help light me while I'm live. I use it as a backlight while I'm working on my ultra wide. And then I actually use it as an edge light. So you can actually see it on the side of my head there. And I use it for pretty much all of my YouTube videos at the moment. And then last but not least, I can't forget to mention my plants. Again, I've got two plants currently on my desk and I just love how it adds a bit of green, bit of nature in my urban office environment. Now, finally, moving on to the storage in my office, I've got a wardrobe behind me, which I kind of just use as a quick access area for different types of gear that I'm using, like my gimbal. In the top drawer, I keep all of my filming accessories, extra cameras and gear that I'm not currently using. In the second drawer, I kind of keep bigger accessories like my tripods or my drone case. And then the bottom drawer is just kind of a bunch of random papers and bits and pieces. And then next to that, I've got this fabric hanging shelf where at the top, I keep a bit of skateboard gear like my helmets and gloves. Also have a space for all my vast array of cables. I really need a better way to organize my cables. So if you've got any ideas, let me know in the comments. And then very last but not least, I've got my bookshelf next to me, which I've used as a charging station in the past, but I've had to repurpose the USB hub that I had behind it. So I don't currently charge anything on it, but I do hang my skateboards from it. I've actually got four different skateboards on this bookshelf, obviously some of my books as well. And then I like to feature my two film cameras. The Mamiya isn't currently working, but the Canon AE-1 program is my main film camera. And this is kind of just where I store it when I'm not using it. So yeah, that is the full office slash YouTube studio tour for 2023. Hopefully it gave you some ideas of how you could set up your own office or your own studio space. If you're interested in a more detailed tour of my primary desk setup, then check out this video here. But other than that, I hope you have an amazing day and I'll see you very soon in the next video.